Medora, and this is a lesson about how to play a country blues style bass line. So it's very common to kind of, you know, combine certain genres, and there's a lot of blues music that kind of pulls a country bass line into the fold, you know. So we learn about shuffles, we learn about slow blues, we learn about kind of funky blues patterns, but a country influenced bass line is super common as well. So to demonstrate this concept, I am using a JJ Cale tune done by John Mayer. They call me the breeze. So the JJ Cale version is awesome. Clapton's done a version. It's kind of become a standard, and other people have done it too. Lots of people have done this song. It's great. The version from John Mayer's record Paradise Valley features Sean Hurley on the bass, who is a great bass player. You can learn about him from my book, Bass Players to Know. And he's just so smooth, so great. Love his playing. And definitely worthy of checking out and giving a listen. So let's talk about how to create this feel, because it's really good to have in your back pocket, especially if you're going to blues jams or just getting together to play with friends. And it's a nice way to kind of bridge the gap between blues and country. There are also a lot of country songs that use a similar feel, like Folsom Prison Blues, the Johnny Cash standard, is one of those tunes. So this is showing you how to kind of pull both of those blues country vibes into one thing. So we're going to start working through this tune. It is in F sharp. So if you're not comfortable with this key, maybe you're used to working in G or F, let's find it. Let's go find our F sharp. We have it right here. It's on the second fret of our E string. But we want to find the octave of it, because we're going to be using certain notes here. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have our F sharp here on the fourth fret of our D string. And this is kind of going to be our home base for this tune, because to create the bass line, we're going to use the root and the lower fifth, meaning that if we started here, we went 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here's the fifth, and here's our octave, and you can see that it's just right below it. So here's our F sharp. Here's the fifth of it, the lower fifth, which is a C sharp. And as soon as I start doing this, it's like, oh, we're playing country music. Rock on, or country on. That's cool. Then to get that feel, we want to integrate dead notes. This is all about having a little percussion, keeping it driving, keeping it moving, and getting that feel. So I'm going to try to play a dead note before the attack of the note, the fretted note. If you want to learn how to play dead notes, check out one of my previous videos. I think it's called How to Play Dead Notes. It's probably called that. Here we go. We're going to play the root note. We're going to play a dead note before striking the fifth, and then a dead note again before playing the root note or the octave again. So you can hear how that dead note, the ba-gum, 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 gives a little more motion to this bass line. Next, we want to break up the bass line a little bit and throw the sixth in as just kind of a fun little passing tone. So you can find 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can find it here or here. I kind of like to play it here. just because this falls really nicely between the fourth and the sixth fret. So I'm going to play it. And when I play this pattern, I'm going to play the whole thing a couple times over the course of one bar or four beats. The first time, I'm not going to use the sixth. I'm just going to play the root and the fifth. The second time, I am going to integrate it. So this is what it'll sound like. Regular with the sixth. And that's going to give it enough space to break up and just add a little something, something. And it just sounds great. So try to get comfortable just doing this. See if you can play it for the first four bars of a 12-bar blues. Here's my second bar. Third. Here's my fourth bar. And then we go to our four chord. So as we're following the 12-bar blues form for this song, our four chord is going to be a B. I went there because I was one, two, three, four. Here's our B. I'm going to move the same pattern, the root with the lower fifth, over to B. So I can find my root here, the lower fifth. Here's that six. And there's the pattern on the B. And then we're going to go back to the F sharp, play it twice. And then we need to find our five chord. We already know where that is. It's right here. It's a C sharp. And we're going to find the lower fifth of that. Now, when I'm on the C sharp, because with the 12 bar form, I'm only on this chord for one measure, I don't often play the sixth. I can sometimes if I want, but you don't have to. You can or you cannot. You can do this and then go to your four, or you could go like this. Or you could go like this. Do a little walk down. It's up to you. You can be creative. You can have options, and that's totally cool. But know that you're only on that chord for one bar. Then we go to our four chord, the B. We've been here before. And we're there for one bar as well. And then we take it back to our F sharp for two bars to finish out the progression. And that is our 12-bar blues. Now I'm going to play the whole thing for you and kind of walk you through it so that you can figure it out and hear it happen all at once. So here we go. A one, a two, a one, two, three, four. Second bar. Third, fourth, go to the B. We're here for two bars. Then we go back to the F sharp. And then we go to the C sharp, our five chord. Four, our B. And back to F sharp for two bars. Play that note, that is the beginning of our next 12-bar phrase. So that is a 12-bar blues played with a country-style bass line using our root and our lower fifth. We've got dead notes for groove, and it's just a great thing to have in your back pocket. Now, there is a lot of motion that can happen in addition to this. You know, there's passing tones, there's chromatic motion, there are things that can take you from one chord to the next, and that stuff is awesome. But get this down first. We'll do another video where we touch upon all of the fun moves to take us around the chord progression. But for now, get this feel under your fingers, get familiar with it, familiarize with F sharp if that's a new key for you, and enjoy. If you'd like tavern notation for this, head over to my Patreon page or my TRUEFIRE channel. You can find it there. And don't forget to check out my website for fun stuff. You can get Bass Players to Know, the book, the mug, the t-shirt, whatever. Learn about Sean Hurley, the bass player on this track, who's so awesome. And happy practicing. Keep it groovy.